Trinity Washington University, and today we are going to talk about digital literacy. My name is Raina.
And I'm Shakia Walker.
And we are in the education class for technology.
So we will be talking about e-safety. So how do you feel about e-safety in a classroom with digital learning?
Yeah, definitely think that if you're going to use technology in any way, it is important to know the privacy settings on the apps that you're using, as well as making the viewership of whatever you're going to upload online to be available and accessible only for parents and family members.
So my input was, I think that we should have no butt-in on the site at all. Mm-hmm. Parents, teachers, staff, or any children-wise, I think everything should be confidentiality. Like, you may put your child, not the name, but like the initials, mm-hmm. so everyone don't know, but 9 out of 10 they will know because they will know the face with the child. Mm-hmm. So, but I think if you post a picture of your child on social media and everyone can see it, I think that we all should put the like button, mm-hmm. or not put bad comments under it.
Great. Now we are going to talk about cultural and social understanding. Shakia, what do you think about cultural and social understanding in the digital literacy platform?
So in the classroom, I think that CDs will work as fine, mm-hmm. for digital learning. The interaction with the children around the world, like you may have different cultures inside of your classroom. So I think that is a good idea as well. And also inviting parents, mm-hmm. inside the classroom to teach their culture or make a video, mm-hmm. and we can put it on a small board and they will learn from it, mm-hmm. as well. So the child can relate and tell its friends.
Yeah, definitely. I think that's important as well, that our students see themselves in the platforms that we're using. They see their cultures. They see, you know, how their family structure looks. It's important for them to see model behavior so that way they know that they are special in their own way.
Then the thought in my head was just thinking that inside of a classroom, you know how you have the dramatic play area and you had the, mm-hmm. children walk around taking pictures of the children in the dramatic play area dressed in the cultural clothes, cooking dinner and holding a conversation. So that was a good idea as well.
Yeah, definitely.
The next topic would be critical thinking and observing. So how do you feel about that, Raina?
So critical thinking and evaluation, how that applies to digital literacy. So I think it's important to have set rubrics and structured feedback for parents when we are looking at the technology that we're using in the classroom. We have to make sure that the students are aware of what they are, what the expectations are. And when we give assignments, we also want to take a look at higher order questions. So how can we ask the student critical thinking questions instead of just taking a picture of an object? And we can go higher into the evaluation as well with our questions.
So I agree with you because I feel like when it comes to that, yes, we do need to introduce the activity inside the classroom so the children will know. Mm-hmm. And they can also teach their parent and inform them about it. So everyone can be on the same page about the learning experience with the technology. Mm-hmm. The apps are very easy to learn, mm-hmm. for certain people, but mm-hmm. children actually need a little push. So you can still send the handout home with the mom and dad, mm-hmm. and they will learn about it as well. So everyone will learn together as a family. So the creativity in a classroom with technology will be taking pictures of your friends to create a storybook, taking pictures of each other, doing activities, or planning an area. And then the children can reflect back to the picture and they can go back and do the same thing they friend did.
Yeah, definitely. And the last point is with digital literacy within practical and functional skills. So technology can be anything you want it to be. It can be as complex as creating your classroom web page, or it can be as simple as using apps that help students trace words or numbers. So with technology, it's important to be comfortable and to feel free to explore different avenues, because at the end of the day, you're the creator.
So we would like to thank you for watching our video.
Yeah, thanks. Bye.